μπορούσε προχθές. Α, δεν ήσουν εδώ, είσαι στο γραφείο.
Το είδα όμως. Μήπως να θέλαμε την πόρτα να παίζαμε το χώρο. Μια που...
Αλέ.
Θα βαλέμε την πόρτα. Άι. Are you coming? You won't be able to go out from that door anymore. Hello, and welcome to Social Dissonance. This is a durational concert. And I have to inform you for some things before we start. For example, you cannot use the front door anymore. You can only exit from that door over there. It's closed. We would like you to stay for the whole hour of the concert, if you can. It's better for us and for you in order for the situation to be built. But if you really need to leave in the middle of the concert, you can still leave by giving us some feedback, so we take something from you also, we learn something from you before you go. Another thing is that we are streaming this online, and we are uploading on YouTube and on Archive, and tomorrow it's going to be projected here. But my idea is that faces are getting lost. There are a lot of faces, it's difficult. And last thing is that we have to speak one by one because of the acoustics of this space, and if we want to be comprehensible, we have to really try to speak one by one. Thank you.
So today, we'd like to make a small experiment because it's been over 100 times we've done this concert, and it came up that it's not even distributed the time that everybody has in order to speak. So you'd like to visualize that by using balloons. You will be given one, and you should blow air while the person on the right speaks. And at the end of this concert, you won't let the air go out. You will give it to them in order to measure how much time each person in this room has spoken. It's also important to us that we notice that men speak more than women. So if you would like to have this conversation about gender issues in general and public speak in particular. So let's form a circle.
Sorry?
Should I translate a little bit? Sometimes they didn't understand.
Translate?
Yeah. Translate. From English into German.
Ah, do you think it's necessary for some people here?
Yeah.
Okay, if it's necessary, yeah, we should try, yeah.
Most people understand most of it.
Okay.
But not.
We try to speak as clearly and as quietly. Okay, if you need to go.
Yeah, just no, I know. I'm trying to push.
Well, if you will just
try.
And you can come back after 5 minutes.
Yeah. Okay.
So don't worry about blowing the exercise one, and keep a rhythm that fits with you. And keep in mind, as we sit, come here, I am blowing a balloon for him, for the person on my right. I'm not blowing the balloon for myself, because while I speak, I cannot blow at the same time. Okay? It makes sense, I guess. Does anybody want to share something?
So I have to blow and then I have to say something.
While you're talking, the person to your right hand, needs to blow air in his balloon or her balloon.
It's very gentle way, the way you blow through. And you may interpret what that means about gender.
That's a way for us to materialize how much time it's one of us speaks. But the conversation could be about how you perceive your gender in the social space, or what's your experience with your playing your gender, or how this works for others, or if it's problematic or not.
You shouldn't have to, but if you want to, you can speak.
So what do I have to say? Is there some question?
You describe this as a concert. I mean, it seems to be more of a discussion than I'm mistaken, or an improvised discussion. Is the definition of a concert an improvised discussion?
Would you like to answer?
The word concert. Mm-hmm. Now you should blow air because I'm going to speak. It's difficult with the camera. Well, what defines a concert to you?
Typically, I associate music with it. Mm-hmm. New music, I suppose, that we're allowing all sounds, but a simple conversation amongst us regarding gender does not fall under my definition of you know it when you hear it or you know it when you see it, of concert.
That's respectable, but the voice, the sound that our voices make does not contribute in any way to your... My voice has a very particular sound, this voice is completely different. We could sing, but we chose to talk.
Okay.
That's how I see it.
Would you like to start by sharing your experience?
Yes.
So maybe.
Okay. He did speak, so you should keep.
You he keep speaks, it. So I should keep.
You blow for the other person. others, you don't love for yourself. So
okay.
You actually you shouldn't have
no, I shouldn't.
You shouldn't, because you didn't speak. I blow for you now because you speak and speak.
Okay. Okay. Gender? I'm white, American, male. Never really had any gender questions. I'm 1.90 meters. I weigh, unfortunately, 110 kilos. What else? I'm retired. Ich bin Rentner. So, yeah. Find a little bit different. We're getting bits and pieces of information as we go along. It seems the explanation to me at the beginning, you had to explain it now three times, you know, which is great, but it just, I keep having to ask, or someone asks, what exactly is, why are we doing this?
Is that the general question, why are we doing this?
Yes, I don't understand everything.
Do you do language? Would you like someone to translate for you?
No.
It's me.
Wait. I'm from Argentina.
You go first, person to your right. No, you go
for her. Okay.
Sorry. Yes, that's my side.
Okay.
You went to the right. The person to the right.
No,
you
the person to the left.
Also, I did it wrong.
So you have to draw.
Very good.
I should have. I'm from Argentina. I am female, and being female in Argentina is a huge problem. At the moment, every 30 hours, a woman is being murdered or raped in Argentina. So I came to Europe to find a better life, because every time I come back home, I'm afraid I might lose my life. So gender for me is something very, very big. And it's very, very hard to leave your country, your family, your friends, because of something that you cannot control, like the way men treat you and see you and talk to you.
Also, my mother's side of the family is from Argentina, and we moved here when I was five. But also for not specifically gender reasons, but more for political economic reasons. And I used to always miss it very much, because of the relationships between people. But as I grew older, I came to realize that it's true what they said, that I couldn't have the life I have here in Europe, down there, because it's so different. And even here, there is this apparent difference when I speak with, I don't know, my male friends, if they're nervous when they're walking down the street at any point, maybe at 3 a.m. And none of them are, and yet there is this difference. I really can't imagine.
Right now I'm living in Denmark, and in Denmark I'm not a female, I'm a person. And it's so weird.
It's amazing.
I'm trying to get used to it because it's healthy. but it's very weird not to be looked at or just go on the bus like any other person. Not first, because you're a woman, just you're a person, so you go in the bus. And it's nice and it's weird.
I don't really believe in gender to begin with. So for me, gender, it's something that can be, everything can have a gender, but it can be a big variety of many genders. And me, myself, I don't identify with any known gender as a male or female. So I don't know, like when you said that when I blew the balloon in a specific way, it has to do with my gender, I'm curious about what kind of gender. You mean, so to talk about gender, what does it mean? Like, what is it to talk about men and women, or is it to talk about the varieties of expressions, like social constructions, like you say, not in a example, like a big social construction. I lived in Spain, and I also lived in Denmark, so I know the macho attitude towards. Yeah. So I don't know if anybody else has some thoughts about what is gender. What do we mean by gender?
Can I say something about who speaks? I speak a lot, or I talk a lot, and I also have the privilege of doing that in situations where other people listen, or at least when they shut up. So what I would like to do is actually take this opportunity to donate my balloon. But the problem is that I've already used my time, and by saying this, I probably also failed performing the action I would like to do. So perhaps I should just have shut up to begin with.
Wahrscheinlich doch jeder gemacht. Du brauchst nicht so da zu fließen, man schaut ein bisschen
länger.
Du brauchst nicht so da zu fließen. Also ich, man muss das nicht machen.
When I came in, I had to make the decision, because it wasn't something she had to do, but something she decided to do.
Du brauchst nicht so doll fließen, also das ist mir jetzt persönlich nicht wichtig.
You don't have to go so hard. It's almost ready.
Es geht ja hier um Kapitalismus und demzufolge dem Narzissmus, wenn ich das jetzt hier so richtig verstehe.
The sheet is about capitalism and narcissism.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. And what is the flyer that was given out to read?
Und die Frage ist ja die Beziehung, glaube ich, zum Narzissmus durch den Kapitalismus und wie wir eigentlich damit umgehen und wie wir das hier darstellen können. Verstehe ich das eigentlich, was wir eigentlich jetzt machen wollten?
The topic is capitalism and how this affects us in a certain sense becomes narcissistic.
Also es geht darum, wie wir eigentlich das jetzt darstellen.
How
so habe ich das
we
verstanden.
Want to present this from our own particular perspective.
Und ich glaube, das ist jetzt völlig egal, wo wir jetzt herkommen oder wer aus welchem Land kommt, aber wir haben natürlich Unterschiedliches erlebt.
It doesn't matter where we come from, but even though we've all experienced different things in our lives through our experience.
Und ich glaube, wir sind alle Menschen und wir haben, glaube ich, alle so die gleichen Empfindungen grundsätzlich
Und es geht ja darum, um den Kapitalismus. Und es geht, glaube ich, darum, dass manche kapitalistische Länder oder auch Leute, die einfach zu viel Geld haben, sage ich mal, andere damit unterdrücken und durch ihren Narzissmus das auch sehr stark darstellen.
The topic is capitalism. There's those who have the haves and the have-nots, and the problems with the haves and the have-nots and the problems that that could lead to. And she feels this is basically the essence of what the sheet is about. And I think she wanted to stress we're all basically people. In a capitalistic situation.
Kapitalismus muss man einfach meiner Meinung nach bekämpfen, damit wir alle mehr zusammengehören. No nation, no was weiß ich, die Grenzen aufheben und dadurch eben eine Solidarität herstellen. Solidarität ist eine Waffe.
Solidarity is a weapon. Capitalism is something we should all be fighting to overcome, basically. It's a system that she says is basically oppressive. And as a human being, we have more or less this Aufgabe.
Give it up.
No, before this duty or whatever to try to stop it. Difficult for us as individuals to try to change things or basically to have an influence as an individual. And,
Individualismus kann nur entstehen, wenn durch den Kapitalismus kein Druck ausgeübt wird. Sonst kann man nicht richtig individuell sein.
Individualism can only exist in a non-capitalistic society or in a situation, and this is something that we have to fight for.
Do you believe that as a woman, you...
It's equal.
It's the same.
I think
it doesn't matter if you're a woman or not, we're all affected.
Do you make the same amount of money as a man in the same position as you? Sorry.
Do you feel equal? Do you make as much money as a man as far as the system is concerned? How does it affect you? Als eine Frau, was ein Mann mehr verdienen würde. Wie kommst du damit zu?
Ja, ganz schlecht natürlich. Also das ist natürlich auch absolut nicht gerecht, würde ich mal sagen, wie das jetzt so in dieser Welt aussieht.
I'm sorry. Would you please give us some feedback before you leave? Can you give us some feedback before you leave?
I don't like it. This is no really conversation. It's just for to put it on YouTube. This is not the kind how I can make communication. It just
because of the camera?
Yes, because of the camera and how you behave. I'm sorry.
What was it in our behavior that you don't find properly in order to communicate?
Yes.
What in our behavior?
Your behavior from you both. You don't explain and you just put as an object with the camera. I'm sorry, it's not that kind of conversation I like.
Capitalism goes under the ground. Das auch denkst.
if there's any fossil season or something.
You can't leave that way. You can tie the balloon up. You can tie it up since you left.
System, they are like taking part in, rather than to want to change the system they're taking part in. And I don't know, as we're talking about gender and being labeled by the society, I recognize that we are, by the system of performance, being labeled by white and black balloons, and that every male person got a white balloon and every female person got a black balloon. And I think rather to leave the performance, maybe we could just exchange the balloons, like, freely to break up or to enlarge the rules of the system in this variable space as a metaphor.
Do you agree?
No.
Okay.
We're supposed to speak, all of us, to do that, no?
To change the... No, you can take...
Just to...
To blow them, we need to talk. Yes.
Maybe. No?
What do you propose?
I think it's good as it is.
Does anybody think it's good as it is? Do you feel that capitalism is good as it is, so you don't actually need to change anything?
Yes, I'm absolutely grateful that I get to decide what I do. And I don't have to donate my labor to the greater good.
Friends. Sometimes I say I don't understand gender, and she always tells me the same sentence, which is white men fear humiliation, the rest of us we fear oppression. So, yes, it's good as it is for me, maybe not for everybody, maybe not for you in Argentina.
I want to try something. I speak a lot, and now there's obviously a limit to how much I can speak, but when that limit is broken, the balloon will blow up, not in my face, but in his face. So I will continue to speak until the balloon blows up in my face. Or perhaps you have a choice to continue blowing or not. Let's see what's going to happen. Do we have any air left? Boom.
it slips. I couldn't.
Well, I have an experience that has been rarely taken into consideration, but for me it's an experience, so it makes it a reality. I have been female bullied somehow by too many gay men, and I have came to the
conclusion that they're misogynists, and that's fucked up.
Do you think that all gay men are...
Obviously some generalization is going to be made, but my experience creates my reality, so...
So, okay.
Maybe it's Greek gay or something. Good.
I was also perceived as someone who is male mansplaining or manspreading while I was participating in social dissonance. My interventions and my will to develop the work was perceived by the other two girls, that they are not here now, as overwhelmingly male. And so they yeah, they told me that, and I try from now on to be cautious about how much time I spend talking or how much I say about the project and what's, yeah. It did by default. They told me it was overwhelmingly, and they said this was because I'm a man, and I don't perceive it like this, but I had to conform with what they said because that was something that they were experiencing, so I didn't know other way. And,
some parts of feminism regarding only having women gathering instead of actually including men in the discussion, whereas they have as important as women. So whenever this situation occurs, I feel it's inefficient.
The gender of the speaker really shouldn't matter. I agree with the girl that was here before that left, said she doesn't identify as any of the two genders, which should really be irrelevant. I don't have a solution to the problem because gender is a thing, but yeah, unfortunately there's a lot, there are all sorts of people in any movement, and even in feminism you've got women who hate men by default, and that also throws a bad light onto the movement itself. And it's just counterproductive.
But I think the amount of this group in the feminist movement is like not the how do you say Mehrheit in English? Like
the
majority. This was a test. yeah, and I think also like what you said, that there are like sometimes only women gathering together and talking about women problems. I think. Like I know it from mixed gender discussions, when there is a person of the other gender or a biological sex, it automatically changes the flow of the discussion. You know, like for example, if a woman got raped and she wants to safely talk about that, she maybe does not want to talk about having men in the group. She's talking about it because it naturally changes the whole setup and the whole flow of the of the discussion. And I think it's easy to confuse these two groups.
you should definitely have like protective blas and like space to talk about this kind of things where you actually are protected from something you fear, but not as a per default conversation.
Okay.
exchange and to be able to ask the questions and not be judged. And then thereafter, I went to an engineering school where I was one of four very few women in an entire room to have sort of the opposite experience. And it is much nicer, I must say, and much less intimidating to be in a room of women. And we're all bright, interested, and yeah, very challenging. And it was a different atmosphere in a different school. Not that there weren't bright women, but in fact, it is more dominated by men in general. So I only wanted to say, but I read recently in the New York Times that there are now spaces, safe spaces for men being created on college campuses. And that has to do with the entire atmosphere in the States at this time, with what is safe to say, by whom, from whom, about what. And others are up in arms, of course, because how can the dominant white male need a protective space for them? But I think it's not necessarily the white male. I guess males seem to need a protective space somehow.
From what?
From the anger. A sense of where they can talk about their insecurities, their own maleness now in today's society. What gender and what does it mean? And you know, it's a very tumultuous time right now in the States, but I don't know. I'm looking at it from the outside in over a single article, but I thought it was a very interesting turn of events when it was last time, many, many years ago. But the safe spaces that need to be created on campus for them. That's very much, yeah, I mean, I can understand why. How to criticize? How can you? I mean, what could they possibly need? But then again, the sensitivity in the other direction as well.
Can someone translate for us, please, in English?
Also, ich meine, einerseits gibt es ja auch schon Ansätze, so Fair Trade, also mit anderen Kulturen. Aber wenn ich jetzt überlege, so Kontinente wie Indien oder Afrika, die haben ja auch eine ganz andere Kultur zwischen Mann und Frau. Also das könnte ich jetzt gar nicht so thematisieren, auch mit Kapitalismus.
Things are going in the right direction with like fair trade and stuff like that, but in other parts of the world, like Africa and India, the cultural differences are too big that she thinks she...
Also man könnte jetzt da das Thema ansetzen mit Gender, Mann und Frau, weil die ja ganz andere...
In India and in Africa, maybe their views of gender and things like that are way different than ours. So maybe we can like start there. Like, what's the difference from our view and their view?
Is anyone originated from these countries, maybe?
I'm not directly from Africa, but my father is, and I know that at least in his part or his upbringing, it was very conservative, and so what I experienced was that
there was the lady that left. Anyway.
Yes, my experience was that their views of gender are very conservative, so they think it's only two genders, like male and woman. Yeah, I don't know how that relates to. Yeah, and that women are playing a much smaller role in society. Like they mostly stay home and do like chores, like look after children and do the cooking. And the male goes out and does the work. So like the women are still dependent on the men, which kind of kind of undermines their value as human beings, I think, which is like not very good.
grandmother to his boy. And on my visits to Nigeria, to the Igbo people, it's, before it was Biafra, the women are very strong and they are together, gathered as in a family. And what we are discussing now on the G20, to give credits for the women to do something, it was there for a long, long time already. So women in a family are staying together, put money in their pockets. There is no bank included, but they are doing it by their own. And when one woman of this society wants to do something, she's asking the society, "What? Give me what money for my economic idea," and she get it, and she will pay it back. But nobody knows because there is no international bank included.
May I ask what was the context of your visit to Africa?
To know my family.
Because
this is my son.
Okay.
Measured is probably the safest place to begin a conversation like this. I like the fact that there are people here that I would have never met or seen or cohorted in my life, and I have the chance to hear all these opinions. And that's what enriches the idea that all these people are here. Not for me, because I don't want to be personally a hypocrite and saying that when I walk down the streets, whoever's from the US understands that better, maybe. But when you get out of Documenta, there are cameras everywhere, that they don't inform you that they film you. So to be honest, I found it a bit too self-conscious to say this camera annoys me and all the rest of the cameras do not annoy me. They annoy all of them. But at least I know why this one is here. And they tell me that if I don't want to be here, I can leave. I can cover my face.
I feel more honest.
Sure, but maybe this is like you could argue that this is not a concept of a safe space, that you that there is a factor that could make people feel insecure that they wouldn't.
I don't know if it's called insecurity or unpleasant somehow, but we do acknowledge that, and we know it's a legal issue as well. That's why we inform everybody. If somebody doesn't feel okay to talk in front of the camera, he can tell us and we can find a solution together.
Sure, I totally disagree and I appreciate the fact that this is put on YouTube.
It's a given, we don't want to impose something on someone here.
Yeah, I just don't or wouldn't agree that this is a safe space for everybody, or not necessarily a safe space, because for me it's like it was a good thing and an inspiring thing to discuss and to see it on YouTube and to participate or let my friends participate in it, but I wouldn't define it as a safe space, like without wanting to judge about the whole thing, but for me it's like a safe space, it's like the definition is that it's closed and that there are only people who, like that you know that are watching. And also, if you know that there's a camera, you don't know every person that is going to watch what you're telling. Mm-hmm. You know, so in this way, maybe it's the same as if we just had this discussion on Friedrichsplatz.
Mm-hmm. More likely. Or if we all have phones with us, so to be honest, we do not know who hears us right now. Could be anybody. So, okay. Do you want that we all go behind the curtains and continue the discussion?
Also, I'm encouraged to speak, and I can say whatever I want, basically, which makes it potentially a very unsafe space. Just as it wasn't too safe when I tried to make the balloon blow up in his face. Although that wasn't a physical action and nothing to do with what I said, still it was like there's a power aspect to it. And if I'm allowed to say whatever I want, I can exert violence on anyone here.
But now not everyone is encouraged to talk. If you look at all the empty buildings, there is like ability to express yourself in public space that a lot of people actually don't have or not have been confronted to. But they were empty.
But it's encouraged that we're not serving violence by saying
in France, a lot of women are elegant, and it's a part of the thing that you have to dress up. And in Germany, no one is actually looking at you when you're putting some makeup or doing an effort. And at first, I thought, as I said, like I work here, and I'm not a gender anymore. I'm just a human being. And sometimes I get frustrated about that. It's like, hey guys, like, and you want also to be genderized at that precise seduction point, maybe.
I get that, but maybe I want that from someone that I want to have that reaction, not every single guy in the street. That's the difference, at least for me. In Argentina, you can have one street without being catcalled, looked at, touched, because they touch you. Have the right to do that. So I like to dress up. I want a specific person to notice that. I don't necessarily want everyone to objectify me. Like, I'm someone that, sorry for my language, but they can fuck and they can do whatever they want. Because it's not like that. I don't see you
extrapolation of that would be to wear a burqa was obviously ridiculous. So I just wanted to say that, like, that if you keep on going with that concept, if you go further, you end up in a ridiculous place. So there's obviously no solution to that because of our biology. That's just how it is to me. Didn't want to be recognized by everyone. What? I mean, everybody can understand. Everybody. So, I think in some Arabic countries, may have thought the same way, and they thought, only I want to recognize you. So I put you on a piece of wool.
Show us that. That's a lot of evidence. So, yes, this jump that you think could be made is from experience, from looking at the past, we think, oh, but that's an extrapolation, but it's not a logical extrapolation. It's just an empirical one, which is
when you said, like, at the end, it's biology, what do you mean?
I think a lot of our interaction, not generally between genders, but all the time, is not dedicated whatsoever.
Dependent
on biology. Dictated by all of your biology. I actually believe that.
There is some, but there's very little that's directly dependent on biology, because you can see that there are several different types of social systems throughout the world. You have matriarchal villages in Africa, you have different conceptualizations of the dynamics between genders and everything, that sort of anything. More dependent on society and what you taught. And if men feel they have the right to sexualize and touch a complete stranger on the street, it's maybe because society has taught them that there will be no consequences for their actions. I don't think it's anything inherently in their biology, because they're men and they're incapable of fighting that. Because women also see an attractive person on the street and, you know, get the urge to yell at them or grope them because it's inappropriate and disrespectful. So, we have a rift in the group.
So I think that, I don't know if it was successful. It was nice to see the balloons, but I don't know if it was successful. It was an idea to distribute voices more possible, and I don't know if it worked. This gender issue is a very conflicting one, and a very difficult one. There are different perspectives from different experiences, and it's a very difficult issue. I don't entitle myself to speak about it so much because I haven't experienced how it is the opposite side. And yeah, that's it.
Und mir ist noch eingefallen, ich sage mal in Deutsch, also wenn wir jetzt über andere Kulturen sprechen, Männer und Frauen, die haben teilweise ja auch noch ganz andere Probleme, Hungersnöte, das ist jetzt von unserem Konzeptionellen so gedacht, dass wir hier praktisch auch in einem Wohlstand leben, wollte ich jetzt einfach mal sagen, ne? Also dass auch anderes total im Ungleichgewicht ist.
We are talking about like from a higher standpoint, like in other parts of the world, men and women are facing different problems, like famine and they're starving people and such. I guess.
Maybe it's a kind of conceptual because we are here very wealthy and yes, some continents are also fighting with a lot of basic essential problems, something like this poorness and starving.
I agree completely with you, but that doesn't mean that there are grapes in Europe. That we are from Greece, there are people starving in Greece. And I do not like to feel guilt of trying to make this discussion in a very elitist place like Documenta, because I think it's a talk that should be made in every single occasion we get. Maybe some other time we raise the question of how the Westerns fucked up the rest of the world, and now they say that that's nothing. How we created the war in Syria, and that the refugees are Germany's, England's, and France's obligation to find out what they're going to do with them. But maybe some other time. But I don't believe that gender issue is not an issue for wealthy people to discuss because there are other problems in the world. I don't think that's how the world works.
Yeah, maybe we can discuss here, but not in, it's not the main topic in the world.
In India, the rates of rapes is actually a very important issue, even though well, 2/3 of the population are starving to death, and yet there are rapes, and they think that culturally that's something they need to stop, and they try to do something about it. For me, this experience is included in all the empty balloons. It's very important, what you said, that we're giving this opportunity to talk. Even though if the matter doesn't affect you or you don't care about it, the lady that left, she stuck on the paper and about capitalism and everything. But I do find it very interesting every time that people come here and don't participate. That's not a judgment, that doesn't mean something about you, at least to me, but it's very important as an experiment, even though our initial experiment failed because we changed balloons and you sabotaged our way to see if women talk more than men, in this particular circumstance. But all in all, I do believe that some of the points that were shared actually do make sense, and even though I may not agree, we can actually create a more productive dialogue on this issue.